we are in fact capable of having these huge realizations, ones that actually overwhelm us, make us feel that we are understanding something that we perhaps shouldn't, that we shouldn't go there, this idea of, you know, where angels fear to tread.
In a material world, true knowledge can come from the things we can see, hear, and touch, because these are what scientists can measure and sometimes turn into beautiful truths.
The more I thought about how it comes to be that our perception of the world at a deep level matches our perception of beauty, it's a puzzle. It poses a deep mystery.
But are there other truths we can discover, which come from pure thought or imagination?
Discovering mathematics is messy, you know, like making love, it's messy. As new mathematics always is. And then moments like that, you say, well, it wasn't me, I didn't discover this. This idea exists out there independently of me, and maybe it wanted to use me to express itself.
Would these ideas also be real and true? Or would they be just figments of our imagination?
We have no instrument by which to record the absolute nature of reality, because whatever instrument that is will at some point be filtered through the lens of consciousness of us.
Professor Ard Louis is an Oxford physicist who believes that reality is rational and mechanical and whose rules are ultimately scientific and mathematical. But he also believes that there are truths that are not part of the material world. Truths placed there by God, a God who wants us to know those truths. Like Professor Louis, filmmaker David Malone also feels that some truths are more than just human inventions. But as a non-believer, the idea of a God who somehow put those truths in the world so we would know them just makes no sense to him. Together, they are on a journey to reconcile their intuitions about truth and meaning, and perhaps even God, to life in a material world. More than any other animal, human beings shape the objects and the world we live in. Not just the physical, the things made by our hands, but those made by our minds as well. And these objects and ideas then shape us in return. But are the only truths those which science can prove? For Professor Louis, the answer is absolutely not because of his belief in God, but because of his study of mathematics.